A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 21st Feb, on the front page you have Anil Ambani, Reliance Communication, guilty of contempt of court, rules Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has given this ruling on the Reliance Communication Ericsson case. So Ericsson is a Swedish telecommunication major. So Reliance has to pay its dues worth 550 crore rupees to the Swedish telecommunication equipment major Ericsson. So this case has gone to National Company Law Tribunal, National Company Law Appellate Tribunal too. And here the ruling which has come is that Reliance Communication has to pay. In the Supreme Court, the administrators of the three companies, also chairpersons of the three companies, also of Reliance companies, said that they would be paying, and they said that they would unconditionally be paying back the dues. Then later they gave another undertaking that this repayment would happen depending on the sale of assets. So actually Reliance wants to sell its spectrum to Reliance Jio, which is led by Anil Ambani's elder brother Mukesh Ambani. But then this deal did not fructify because Department of Telecommunication, it is said, did not give a no objection certificate. So since it did not rectify, means they don't have the money, means they won't pay. So when it was said that they have to pay, then and also the Supreme Court highlights that how the three chairpersons gave this conditional undertakings that if the sale happens, then they will pay. So this happened. This they gave on August 9, 2018, when the Supreme Court order to pay came on August 3, 2018. So means in such a short span of time, they just gave this undertaking when the Supreme Court says that it had given them on August 3 a 120-day period window to pay back to Ericsson. So this shows that they had no intention at the very least of adhering to the time limit and repaying. So that is why now they have been held guilty of contempt of court, and it is said Reliance Communication must pay 453 crore rupees to Ericsson in 4 weeks, else Anil Ambani faces jail time. In the inside pages, you also have this complete timeline. You can see the Swedish telecom equipment maker Ericsson had moved National Company Law Tribunal in September 2017 to recover its 1,150 crore rupees dues from Reliance Communication. So Reliance announced 25,000 crore deal in December 2017 to sell telecom assets to Reliance Jio. So that was the deal announced, but financial creditors opposed Ericsson petition claiming first right to asset sale proceeds. So first asset sale should happen, and if the dues can be paid, then NCLT need not be opposed. So Ericsson moved Supreme Court, agreed to one-time settlement for 550 crore rupees to be paid by September 2018, but Reliance Communication failed to pay even this. This is half of 1000, less than half of 1150 crores. So this 550 crore was to be paid by Reliance by September 2018, but it failed to pay. It says the Reliance Jio deal was delayed. So that has been more than a year the deal was announced. So in October 2018, Ericsson moved Supreme Court for contempt, and Supreme Court gave Reliance Communication 3 months to pay again. Now it said if you fail to pay again, then of course action will be taken by the Supreme Court. So same reason given that Reliance Jio deal did not move ahead, so Reliance Communication cannot pay back to Ericsson. So Ericsson now has filed second contempt petition in Jan 2019, because on first contempt petition it was still given 3 months time, and now in the second contempt the Supreme Court has ruled that it has to pay within 4 weeks now. That's the order. Then next is Pakistani convict killed in Jaipur jail. So this is 50-year-old Pakistani national serving a life term in Central Jail in Jaipur, who was killed. He was convicted of unlawful activities as such and terror funding case. So he was allegedly killed by a group of inmates after a quarrel. He had a head injury and he died. Then below you have India pitches for global action against terrorism. So Saudi Arabian Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman is on a visit to India. He has already visited Pakistan, and now India has pitched here for global action against terrorism. Saudi Arabia has offered intelligence that it would provide intelligence to India. And this is 48,239 crore rupees package for 12 banks cleared. So center has approved a recapitalization package for 12 public sector banks. On page 7, you have biggest ever Aero India opens with tribute to deceased pilots. So this is the Aero India show in Bengaluru. It's a 12th edition, which brings back civil aviation to the largely military show. So here you can see. So Tejas, which is world's lightest fighter aircraft, also participated. It said it is battle ready now. So this is the Tejas aircraft flying over the US Air Force's Boeing C-17A Globemaster III. And below you have, where are the green crackers, asked Supreme Court. So the Supreme Court had called for non-polluting green crackers to be allowed, and still it says that green crackers have not been popularized. So the ban on crackers has affected the livelihood of 4 lakh workers, and you know, it has resulted in closure of around 974 firecracker units in Sivakasi, Tamil Nadu alone. So the green crackers have to be manufactured. So the Supreme Court is now questioning on this issue. On the editorial page, the first editorial is the big fight. So this is regarding bipoles, assembly bipoles as such. So for in Tamil Nadu, so this it says for AIADMK, the political party in Tamil Nadu, assembly bipoles are more important than Lok Sabha elections. Then this is with reservations. So this is regarding reservation for Gujjars. So 103rd amendment as such has been passed, bill has been passed, which is said to protect the its objective is to protect the new quota for Gujjars in Rajasthan. But whether it will stand the test of constitutionality will have to be seen. The lead article, the employment test. So this is regarding the controversy which we have seen, how the employment data as such shows that employment is at a very low. So the labor force, the article says, may have actually shrunk while the Modi government has been in office. So this is a coverage on that. And this is more symbolic than punitive. So this is regarding India's trade related action against Pakistan, that is revoking MFN status. So it says this will encourage informal trade and propel Pakistan to look for markets beyond South Asia. Then on the op-ed page, you have a modern story of Eklavya. So this is regarding the education condition in the country. Still, it says the education system continues to exclude many people's histories, worldviews and cultures. It says our society is filled with committed teachers, but they are silenced by the powers that run education institutions. So they are handmaiden for their personal and political ambitions. So this is a critique on that. And this is the private sector in public health. So this is one-sided view given on how private sector in public health can be beneficial. It says it can provide services and capital as well. On international page, you have Putin threatens West with new missiles. So now Russia has warned US against deploying any new weapons in Europe after the collapse of the intermediate range nuclear forces treaty. So this is the treaty which has collapsed now. So after this, now Russia does not want US to have any new weapons in Europe. If it does, then Putin threatens that it will also bring in new missiles. Then on business page, you have Jet we see turnaround in 6 to 9 months. So we have seen earlier too how Jet was unable to repay its debt, and now it is said that a resolution plan has been finalized which projects airline to report profit from October to December 2019 quarter. So this is the coverage on that. And we have already seen this news regarding Reliance Ericsson case, continuation of the front page news. And this is regarding the recapitalization package in detail too. So it's for all banks, prompt corrective action banks and also non-prompt corrective action banks. So prompt corrective action banks are one whose NPAs, non-performing assets, are high. So they need capital from the government. But then there are also non-PCA banks which have been provided with this package. Then this is GST Council returns filing deadline. No decision yet on royalty. So GST Council had its meet through video conferencing, and here you can see it has decided to extend the deadline for filing returns. On royalty, there is no decision yet. And this is Dr. Reddy's relaunches generic version of Suboxone in US. So this was the patent case in which Dr. Reddy's won, and now it has launched its generic version. So Suboxone, which is a drug for opioid dependence treatment. So it's an opioid means opium related products, opioid dependence treatment drug, Suboxone. So it is manufactured by British drug maker Indivior. So it had the patent, but then Dr. Reddy's has developed the generic version, which has now been allowed to be sold in USA by the courts. So it has been relaunched. And on the last page you have, meet the sea squirt that sucks plastic particles from the ocean. So this is a creature which can help scientists measure pollution accurately. So it's a rubbery sea creature with an irritating habit of clinging to ships and invading beaches, but it could help measure plastic pollution. It can filter tiny particles from the ocean and store them in its soft tissue. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com in the current affairs section. And here you will find the PDFs, daily current affairs PDFs also available, plus also monthly compilation PDFs are available for download. You can click here. So this is there. And detailed current affairs video lecture is also there, a sample video provided here, and the details of the course provided here. So that is it. Thank you.